Producer Tim's New Balance shoes.
Oh!
Whoa! Ow!
Oh, oh my gosh!
Ow!
Oh. Oh my God! Oh. Oh my God! Oh. Why was I pinching myself?
Dan's down. Dan's down.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is the start of the new NHL season. John, we have that hockey theme we asked for. Here we go.
Now, we're saving it. Don't want to wear it out.
That's fair. That's fair. I wish we owned it and could play it anytime we wanted. Dan, the Leafs, the Sens kicking off the NHL season. Very exciting. Battle of Ontario. But there was one question on everybody's mind.
That's right. The team said, Mike Babcock said, we will have a captain in the first game of the season. Who is it?
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the 25th captain in franchise history from Oakville, Ontario, number 91, John Tavares.
Oh, yeah. There he is. You thought, and look at this. On Monday, the team brought in his wife and new baby and put the baby in a jersey with the C before bringing it to Tavares to give him the news.
There you go. Really special.
Very special moment. Opening shift of the game. It's the Sens, it's the Leafs. The season is underway. Mitch Marner and Kasperi Kapanen misplayed the puck. Former Leaf Connor Brown works down low. Centers, Brady Tkachuk.
Turned it over inside the line.
He scores. Sens capitalize on the turnover. It's 1-0 Sens, 25 seconds in. 19-year-old Rasmus Sandin, the Leafs' 2018 first-round pick, making his NHL debut. It's tied in the second. Sandin, shot, stop, rebound, center to Trevor Moore.
Sandin on the other side is
scores. Sandin picks up his first career NHL point. Tarana has the lead. Flashing back preseason, Austin Matthews chirps, sends forward Scott Sabourin for trying to. He's trying to check out the name. The old, who are you? Who are you? Okay, Sabourin made the team. Sends, break in, Sabourin. He's left all alone. Takes the feed, beats Freddie Anderson. Sabourin has spent the last seven seasons in the AHL, scores in his NHL debut to tie it up. Just a few minutes later, Austin Matthews.
Kachuk overskates the puck and then falls. And the Leafs have an odd man rush going the other way with Nylander. They score! Matthews! Holy mackerel, what a turn of events!
Matthews, named one of three assistant captains for the season, restores the lead on the power play. No-look feed from Marner. Gets it over to Matthews. One-timer, top corner, second of the game. That's the ninth goal Matthews has scored in four season-opening games. Yeah, he likes opening night. Leafs up two after two in the third. Leafs, they've got some talent. And a pair of newcomers go to work. Tyson Barrie, with a spin move, feeds Ilya Mikheyev. Backdoor. The score. It's a backdoor score. Barrie picks up 2 points in his Leafs debut. Mikheyev scores his first career NHL goal. Leafs up 5-3, 9 seconds, sends net empty. Matthews going for the hat trick. Can't put it home. Uh-oh, that didn't look good. His skate caught rookie Erik Brännström in the face. Brännström needed stitches, but the Sens think he'll be good to play Saturday. Oh. The Leafs take the season opener, 5-3. Yeah, Austin Matthews, 9 goals in 4 career season openers? That's nuts. Leafs beat the Sens for the first time in 6 all-time season openers. And Austin Matthews becomes the 4th player in NHL history to score in his first 4 season openers. Sergei Fedorov, Dave Anderchuk, and Dick Clapper, the other. Dick Clapper's real name? Aubrey Victor Clapper. It's from Hastings, Ontario, outside Peterborough. And it's now time for the season premiere of Masters Lock. So we bring in Mark Masters from Scotiabank Arena. Mark, a new era begins in Toronto Wednesday night with John Tavares donning the C for the Leafs. What was the initial reaction around the room?
Well, I mean, in the building was electric tonight, of course. There was such a build-up for that. And I think in the room after the game, a lot of people basically saying he's the choice. I mean, you can't go wrong with John Tavares. The guy is a consummate professional. The way he deals with the media, nothing seems to faze him. And so that was the consensus really in the room, is Johnny's our guy. That's what Morgan Riley said. So I think that pretty much sums it up.
Mark Masters, Auston Matthews is not the captain. He is an alternate. But is there a better player in the league on opening night than 34?
Probably not, just based on the statistics. It's pretty incredible. He really didn't want to get into that post-game, his explosive nature in these opening nights, but he certainly has a sense for the occasion, and that was on display because he elevated in that second period and kind of just got this building rocking. I mean, we heard an Auston Matthews chant here. We hear Freddie chants. We hear Auston Matthews chants. We heard a John Tavares chant at one time last year, but Matthews seems to strike a chord with the fan base here, and he was incredible again on an opening night.
Mark, you can captain our ship anytime, buddy. Thanks for this.
No worries. I'm looking for story ideas with now that the captaincy has been settled, so let me know if you guys can.
He's hilarious. Hey, we found the hockey song, the hockey theme. Thanks, Tim. Great job. You know, going into the season, a lot of uncertainty surrounding the Edmonton Oilers, the Vancouver Canucks, and Elias Pettersson's name. I say Pettersson because that's what we were calling him during his Calder-winning rookie season. But then on Wednesday, Ryan Rashog asked him this.
Has everybody been saying your name wrong?
Depends if you're Swedish or Canadian.
How have Canadians been saying it? How do you want Canadians to say your name? We got to get it on the record because I hear it.
So I think Elias Pettersson.
Okay. So now it's Pettersson. Okay, not Pettersson. Pettersson. Right, Elias?
Pettersson, is whatever. Pettersson, yeah.
Oh, I'm confused. I'm sorry. I'll call him EP40 now. Okay, call him EP40. It's the Oilers, it's the Canucks, and it's Connor McDavid in the lineup against Vancouver. Vancouver has a streak of 5 straight season opening wins. Just over 5 minutes in, Zach Cassian all over the rebound. Nice feed to Leon Draisaitl, the Deutschland dangler. 50-goal scorer last season, gets his first nice and early 1-0 Edmonton. Later in the first, stretch pass tipped right to the stick of JT Miller, but he cannot beat Mike Smith. Smith signed that one-year deal in the offseason and got the start ahead of Mikko Koskinen, denying one of the Canucks' new acquisitions. McDavid, joined on the first line by James Neal and Joachim Nygaard. And the captain gave his thoughts on potential chemistry.
We don't have a ton of experience together, but I mean, Neil and I played one game. Nags and I have played no games, so it's definitely going to be a little bit of a feeling out process.
Gene Principe featured in a future Scrum Lurkers. Neil off the boards, Nygaard. Can't beat Jacob Markstrom. Nygaard playing his first career NHL game after 7 years of pro hockey in Sweden. Halfway through the frame, Canucks man advantage. After the Oilers got hit for too many men, Alex Edler tees it up. Another look shows McDavid had his helmet knocked off. New rule this year is you have to put your helmet back on or head off the ice. He's focused on that, not able to cover Edler, and now we're tied at one. And now the Oilers are on the power play. Nice puck movement leads to a great opportunity for Alex Chiasson. Markstrom is there. Kick save and a beauty. There's the new Oilers GM. Currently, we are in the third period, and it is still a 1-1 hockey team.
Hockey game.
A 1-1 hockey game. Dan, interesting note here by our stats guy, Hound Dog Harrison. One of these two teams will be 1-0 after winning this game.
He's right.
McDavid has 21 points in 17 career games against the Vancouver Canucks. That's probably a better note.
Caps Caps and Blues, defending champs, taking the Stanley Cup for one final spin prior to the new season. And then they raised the first Stanley Cup banner in the franchise's 51-year history. My buddy Boots was there. Opening minute of the game.
Are you kidding me?
Blues score less than a minute into the season. 1-0 Cup champs. Mid-first power play. Justin Falk to Alex Pietrangelo. Falk making his Blues debut, acquired from the Hurricanes last week. Blues are up 2-0. Alex Ovechkin entered 42 goal shy of 700 for his career. Under five to play in the first. Ovechkin gets around Jay Bouwmeester and beats Jordan Binnington. It's the first time since 1962 that the last two Stanley Cup champs are playing each other on opening night. Tied at two in the second, Braden Schenn to Vladimir Tarasenko. Braden Holtby, Fermé's Laporte covers it on the goal line. Falk springs Ryan O'Reilly. Hey, turned aside by Holtby. After getting beaten on two of the first three shots of the game, Holtby settled down, made 20 saves. This one needed overtime. The extra session, Jakub Vrana. Circles, scores. The Caps spoil the Blues banner raising night as they win their opener 3-2.
And the Capitals take game one. Last of four opening night games, Sharks, Golden Knights. First meeting since San Jose's wild playoff comeback last year. Under 4 minutes in, Vegas power play. Mark Stone collects and beats Martin Jones. Stone, the deadline day acquisition from Ottawa last year, makes it 1-0 Knights. Under 2 minutes later, Sharks turn it over deep in their own zone. Riley Smith makes him pay. Vegas up 2-0. Should mention Erik Karlsson not playing in this game due to personal reasons. Logan Couture colliding knee on knee with Nate Schmidt. Schmidt in pain. Play continues. The Vegas trainer runs onto the ice as play is continuing. No whistle blown, so he's got to go back over the boards. Schmidt putting no weight on that left leg as he was helped off the ice. He did not return. No penalty called on the play. Now 2-1 in the second. Cody Glass making his NHL debut. Portland Winterhawk from Winnipeg, Manitoba, buries a gorgeous pass from Max Pacioretty. First player to ever be drafted by the Golden Knights, and they're up 3-1.
The American League wildcard game had a lot to live up to Wednesday night, considering the drama the NL wildcard game produced the previous night. The Nationals won it in dramatic fashion. Teams battle all year to play a one-game elimination game. Jay Onwright, pictured here, had a great idea on how to remedy that. Play a best of three, day-night doubleheader one day, and if need be, a deciding game three the next night. Boom, brilliant. Owners would love it, fans would love it.
They don't even have to give me a cut.
Oakland lost in last season's wildcard game to the Yankees. Tampa back in the postseason for the first time since 2013. First batter of the game. Yeah, that was also the first pitch of the game. Donnie Diaz got off the aisle on Sunday. He was a surprise starter, so he leads it off. Bottom half, A's load the bases. Charlie Morton gets out of it. And this is a flyer from Jerickson Profar. So a massive missed opportunity for Oakland. Avisel Garcia. He's up. Top two. What? And Garcia no doubter to center. 54,000 of the Coliseum silenced. It was an MLB wild card record crowd. In the fifth, Tommy Pham says, well, I want to do that too.
Let me.
Ray's fourth home run of the game ties a franchise postseason record. Tampa up 5-1. They carried that lead into the ninth, so would we have the same drama that we had in the NL wild card? Rays one out away. Marcus Semien goes down swinging. No drama here. Oakland left nine men on base, went 0-for-4 with runners in scoring position. Tampa wins their first winner-take-all game since 2013. So the Rays are off to the ALDS for a date with the Astros. Yikes. That's right. If they played a best of three.
Got a couple more chances.
So here's what the AL playoff schedule looks like. Both series begin Friday. Rays and Astros starting at 2 Eastern. Then the Twins and Yankees at 7 Eastern. Still to come, putting the captain talk to rest, Kyle Dubas explains Toronto's choice next. Bianca Andreescu facing Elise Mertens in the second round of the China Open. She beat Mertens in the quarterfinals at the U.S. Open. Then she won the title. On serve, opening set, Andreescu with a forehand volley. She broke Mertens, taking the set 6-3. Down 4-1 in the second, Andreescu cross-court winner. Andreescu, the number 6 ranked player in the world, holds serve. Mertens up 5-4, set point. Andreescu comes forward, and Mertens forehand finds the net. Andreescu holds serve and squares the set at 5-all. Second set needed a tiebreak, down 1-0. Andreescu, desperation shot to keep the rally going. Mertens, okay, got that one across, but Mertens, net!
There you go.
Andreescu refusing to give up on the point. She had a battle throughout this one. But Andreescu, match point. Mertens, forehand, it is long. Andreescu was pressured, but she takes it in straight sets, and she's now won a WTA Tour season high 16 consecutive matches. It's the longest unbeaten streak since Victoria Azarenka won 17 consecutive in 2016.
She cannot be stopped.
I love that sound effect.
Here we go. Heading over here. This is gonna be fun. Oh, it's always exciting when hockey's back, right?
Watch out for this table, it sneaks up on you.
Yeah, does it ever, Dan, does it ever. During the first intermission of Wednesday's Sens Leafs game, Toronto Maple Leafs GM Kyle Dubas addressed naming John Tavares the 25th captain in franchise history.
We think he was a great choice, but I think one of the major benefits that we had was that we had a number of candidates for the position, and we were able to go through each player. Not that there was anything overly negative about any of them. It was legitimately a case where we felt we had a number of players that could carry that honor, and in the end, just decided as a collective group that John fit the role the absolute best at this time, and that's how we were going to go ahead. Everything's already been written and said about him, and we haven't learned anything new about him since he's come here, and I think that's really, in the end, the reason for it. He's everything that we thought he would be, and there's nothing negative about him whatsoever, so it's great for him and a great honor for he and his family.
Did anything change after the filling?
No, not at all. This was exactly what we had planned, what we had discussed well before that size, so it didn't affect our decision making whatsoever.
I will say this.
What's that?
Morgan Riley, who a lot of Leaf fans thought should be the captain, he will be the alternate throughout the year, and then two other players will split the other alternate. You got your Mitchell Marner, maybe the greatest actor in Leaf history, and Austin Matthews. So there you go.
No one can complain about Tavares.
I think it's an excellent, excellent pick.
Evander Kane will not appeal his 3-game suspension for physical abuse of an official. That's according to Bob McKenzie. Kane received an automatic ban under Rule 40.4 after he was ejected from the Sharks' final preseason game where Kane shoved a linesman.
So on Tuesday, Golden Knights winger Ryan Reeves, who's had a bit of a history with Evander Kane, was asked about Kane's suspension.
What's your reaction to Evander Kane getting suspended and that he won't be on the ice tomorrow night?
Poor Evander. So tragic. I wish he was on the ice. It's always more fun when he's on the ice.
Do you think that there's any legitimacy to what he said about being treated differently than other players?
No. I don't really know. I don't understand why you would say that.
I think just the way the ref tried to break things up and ended up taking him down, he felt like he was victimized. So.
Well, yeah, he's weak. Gets taken down by a ref. It happens.
How excited
gotta get in the gym, no?
He's a classic Winnipeg guy.
Yeah.
That's a funny one. Kane eligible to return October the 8th against the Preds. Geno Malkin is set to start his 14th season in the NHL. Can you believe that? And this year, he will be joined by fellow countryman Alex Galchenyuk.
How do you ask him for the puck in Russian? What do you say to him in Russian on the ice?
Same, like, give me puck. It's always easy, like, when you like speak Russian, because you thinking quicker in Russian, you know, like sometimes like when I play like with defenseman, like, and I need to remember like wall, you know, wheel, you know, like something, sometimes I forget these words.
Okay, we already have the Alex Ovechkin, swear to God.
Yeah.
Now we need give me puck.
Give me puck is going to be the saying across the NHL this year. That's a meme now.
Malkin looking for a rebound season, had 21 goals last year. Previous season he had 42.
If the Pittsburgh Penguins marketing team is watching and you don't have give me puck t-shirts ready to go at the new Igloo, approximately what, tomorrow? Mm-hmm. Are they at home against Buffalo, Tim? Or are they in Buffalo? I can't remember. Either way, get those t-shirts made. Give me puck. They're at home, so give me puck. Let's go, Pens.
At the it's the PNG or the PPG? It's the PPG paints.
The paint box.
Yeah.
The paint can?
Prior to Wednesday night's games, these were the odds to win the Stanley Cup. Caesars Sportsbook has the Lightning as the favorites with 8-1 odds to win it all. Last season, Tampa's 62 regular season wins tied the 95-96 Detroit Red Wings for the most in NHL history. Leafs are ahead of the Bruins on the odds board, despite being eliminated in the first round of the playoffs by Boston in back-to-back years. Defending champs? Ooh. 50-1 no respect for
no
the Blues.
They're like
Rodney Dangerfield.
And they added Falk, and Falk looked great on opening night. Made some beautiful stretch passes.
I just mentioned Rodney Dangerfield. Do you think people don't know who he is anymore?
The young people don't know who Rodney Dangerfield is.
Look him up.
Yeah.
He's in Caddyshack.
Back to School was a good movie. And maybe just check out his stand-up, because he was a real pioneer. And he was great on The Tonight Show. This has been Rodney Dangerfield talk on Jay and Dan. Hey, Hockey Canada has introduced BFL Canada as an international marketing partner supporting women's hockey. This is a 5-year agreement. BFL Canada is a longtime supporter of women's hockey. It's going to focus on growth and development, opportunities for female players and coaches. And if you're wondering what BFL Canada is, Dan?
It's one of the largest risk management, insurance brokerage, and employee benefits consulting services firms in Canada.
Any positive news involving women's hockey in our country, we're all for it. I love this. Yeah. I love this news as we continue to push toward a real women's league. Wouldn't it be great if the NHL was involved, and right? It would just be fantastic. Just like the WNBA and NBA, it'd be a great thing. Hockey card time. I know you've been waiting for this.
Yeah, hockey cards are back at Timmy's. $1 with a beverage, $1.99 without a beverage.
All right, Dan. So you're going to go first.
Bad boys up.
Dan's going first here. Who do you got?
Zibanejad?
Nice.
Ovi, there he is. I believe the third or fourth Austin Matthews, and I already have Sharpie on my finger from the show.
We get a lot of Austin cards. We get a lot of 34s. So cameraman Glenn's going to get an Austin.
Yeah, he always gets all the Leafs.
He loves Austin. Who do I have here? Oh, Stammer. Friend of SportsCenter with Jay and Dan.
That's grew a good up, one. It's a good
grew
get.
Grew up very close to the studio here. I also have some Sharpie there.
Some more over
Sharpie
there.
Sharpie over there. So, okay, so Stammer. More Ovi.
Yeah, there you go. You
look at that. Right, okay. Now, aren't these beauties? Folks, you got to get to Tim Hortons and get some more of these cards for yourselves and your kids.
Doobie, doobie, doo. What a guy.
There you go. Get your cards at Timmy's. When we come back, the best Jannies from the NHL season so far. Funny one, producer Tim.
Let's dive into the Jannies. It's beginning to look a lot like fall. My oldest daughter put on Christmas music in the car today. It was Michael Bublé, though.
That seems a bit much.
Hey,
Costco?
I never say no to Michael Bublé. Austin Matthews, second goal of the game.
The defending Stanley Cup champions against the defending Stanley Cup champions from the previous season, and Alex Ovechkin is already in mid-season form.
Tyson Barrie, nice play. Feeds Ilya Mikheyev. Scores. First in the NHL. Give him the puck.
Let him take it home. Put it on his bedside table.
AHL, they're still doing it. Nikolai Kovalenko.
I gotta start following at KHL on Instagram. Again, back to the Caps and Blues. Braden Holtby makes not one, not two, not... No, actually three. Yeah, three big saves. 22 saves on Wednesday as the Caps spoil the Blues home opener with a victory. For our last Janny, ladies and gentlemen,
picked up again by McDavid.
Connor McDavid. Number 97 on your program.
And
the captain of your Edmonton Oilers.
The great reacts of Ken Holland seeing that and react. He's like, we got him?
Yeah.
He's on my team?
This is why I took the job, literally, because of that guy. Dan, when we come back, stay tuned. You're watching Jay and Dan.
With the NHL season starting this week, fans and organizations, they're welcoming plenty of new faces to their teams.
And we're no different here at SportsCenter with Jay and Dan. We've had new interns starting this week. We can assure you it's very hard to get an internship on this show. You have to go through a rigorous interview process, as we see in the newest edition of the Jay and Dan Intern View. Thank you for joining me here in producer Tim's office. Why is your name Bradshaw?
My parents, they decided that it was better than naming me Brianne if I was a girl.
They thought you were going to be a girl?
That's what their original thought was, yeah.
Yeah, and so they named you Bradshaw.
Yeah.
Okay. You were supposed to do this interview yesterday. You didn't show up for work. Where were you?
I was not here. I was at a concert.
You were at a concert, on the second week of your internship.
Yes, I was.
Did you tell anyone?
No.
Do you think you're going to make it in this business?
Not anymore.
Name one thing that makes producer Tim mad.
You guys?
No. Everything.
Everything, okay.
Are you a bath or a shower guy?
Shower.
No, you're a bath guy.
Okay.
You're a soaker, I can tell. Dan can't read. Do you believe me?
Yes.
You're right. Show everyone at home what interning looks like. Go. That's just putting your hands up. That was stupid. Who did you see in concert?
Injury Reserve?
That's not even a band. Injury Reserve?
Yeah.
Get out of here. Go.
Yeah. That way?
Yes. Just. Injury Reserve, my ass. It's not a real band. No chance.
The IR.
Bradshaw. He wasn't joking. He went to a concert. And just didn't tell anyone. Wish I had the
cojones
of a millennial or Gen Z.
Should we point out again, we've said this before, since 2002, we have not missed a day.
Not a single day. We never will.
The Jay and Dan podcast. We talked to Darren Dreger this week, and he dishes some juicy dirt on a lot of people that we work with. And also, the Jay and Dan podcast, the first ever live tour continues this coming weekend. We're in Calgary Friday, Edmonton Saturday, eventbrite.ca. Just a couple tickets left. Highlight of the night.
Now on the other side, Tavares wins the puck.
Mitch Marner.
Marner
reverse.
Backhand, hooks the puck back.
To Matthews. Opening night is his Super Bowl. As he scores again. You blew it. We point out our errors. Look at this. Compiled by Andrew Zwarich. Again, we still need a new photocopier. Guys, can we just...
Honestly, Bell Media, send us a new photocopier. Just one. I gotta say, we've been doing pretty well lately. We haven't been messing up that much.
And,
why do you think that is?
You know what? Because we had some pep in our step on this show because it was the opening night of the season.
Yeah.
We had brand new highlights.
It was fun. Let's hear that hockey theme again.
Every highlight is brand new. But it was a fresh start.
Yes, it sure was. Thanks for watching our program. Glenn, you okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Here we go.